So we have discussed how to qualitatively describe the motion of rigid bodies moving in a plane. Let's do quantitative analysis now. So we'll start by looking at rigid body. And we will choose two points, let's say A and B on this rigid body. All right. And we will pick our reference frame to indicate the positions of these two points, let's say RA, RB, okay. So we can write that position of A can be given as position of B as a reference point plus position of A with respect to B, which is essentially this vector, right? This is R of A with respect to B. So let's say R of A with respect to B is this distance, R of A with respect to B, which is the magnitude part of this vector, times some unit vector UR hat along that direction. So if we just look at the vector R of A with respect to B, that's what we are writing over here, right? So in this direction, UR hat is a unit vector, and the length of this line is given by R of A with respect to B, okay? So this is all done with respect to a translating frame, right? This is what we have seen before as well. So this is a translating frame. What is a translating frame? A frame that is not allowed to change its orientation. So when you write R of A with respect to B, that is essentially locating a frame at point B, which is also translating, which is not changing its orientation. Once you allow a frame to rotate, then all bets are off. This kind of analysis will not work. We will see what would happen when you admit rotating frames as well later in this chapter. So let's take the derivative of this equation right over here. So what do we get? We get velocity of A equal to velocity of B plus d over dt of R of A with this v, which we can write as this, right? Okay. So this is equal to velocity of B plus d over dt of R of A with respect to B. So that's the derivative of this length times UR hat plus R of A with respect to B times d over dt of UR hat, right? So this is a derivative of product of two functions. So that equates to this. Okay. So this is equal to VB plus, what is this quantity? D over dt of R of A with respect to B. That is basically the rate of change of this length of this vector. But over time, the length of this vector is not going to change because the rigid body assumption says that the distance between the two points as the rigid body moves should not change, right? Which means that this quantity is actually equal to zero. So we are left with R of A with respect to B times derivative of this unit vector. So what is this unit vector telling you? This unit vector is basically giving you the direction of vector AB, right? That's what this is giving you. If rigid body is allowed to rotate, then this vector, unit vector UR hat, or the direction of this line is going to change, which means that this quantity is actually not equal to zero. So this is not equal to zero right over here. Okay, so if it is not equal to zero, then what is this quantity? So you will recall before, and when we discussed the kinematics of particles, we talked about derivative of unit vectors, right? So this is derivative of a unit vector UR hat. What is the derivative of a unit vector given as? So d over dt of u hat is equal to any unit vector is given as the rate at which this vector is rotating, and the rate at which this vector is rotating is given by this vector quantity called theta dot k hat. So k hat is a unit vector perpendicular to the plane of this figure over here. Okay, and u hat is a unit vector in this plane. So if this plane is xy, then u hat lies in the xy plane, and theta dot is pointing along k hat direction, which is perpendicular to this plane, cross the unit vector itself. So if you don't remember this relationship, I would like you to review that particular module where we talked about, that particular video in the module number 2 where we talked about derivative of a unit vector. So derivative of unit vector is given as the rate at which it is rotating times k hat, direction of rotation, cross itself. Okay, so let's substitute that over here. So what do we get? We get theta dot k hat cross ur hat, right? Okay, so let me write this as vb plus theta dot k hat cross, and I'm going to take r of ab inside and write this, right? The reason I'm doing this is because this quantity is basically same as this vector r of a with respect to b. So let's substitute that. So we get velocity of a equal to velocity of b plus theta dot k hat cross r of a with respect to b. Now, what is theta dot k hat? Theta dot k hat is basically telling the rate at which the unit vector along AB is changing, right? Now, AB is a property of this rigid body. Every line in this rigid body is rotating with the same rate because it's a rigid body. So if line AB rotates by 45 degree, if you pick another line in this rigid body, let's say given by CD, in the same amount of time, CD will have also rotated by 45 degree, right? So the rate of change of the orientation of this rigid body is a property of the rigid body, okay? So we call this theta dot k hat to be a quantity called the angular velocity of AB cross r of a to b. So omega AB, even though it seems to indicate as if it is just the rate of change of orientation of line AB, is really not just about line AB. It's any line in this rigid body. So you pick any 2 points and you form a line joining those 2 points, that line will also rotate with the same angular velocity as AB. Okay, so it's really a rigid body property. So sometimes people may also write this simply as omega 0 to indicate this 0th rigid body, or omega 1 or omega 2, but it would be nonsensical to ever write omega of A. Okay, something like this will be completely nonsensical because there is no such thing as angular velocity of a point. You cannot meaningfully talk about the angular velocity of a point. All right, okay, so this is the relationship that we get. And that's our fundamental velocity relationship for analyzing the velocity of rigid bodies moving in a plane. Now let's spend a couple of minutes looking at this relationship and ask ourselves, what are we really looking at over here? Okay, so this relationship is basically giving you velocity of a point A. If you know the velocity of point B, okay, so B is an arbitrarily chosen reference point, and the angular velocity of this rigid body, right? We assume that we know the geometry of rigid body completely, so these kinds of position vectors would be always known to us at every instant, okay? So the only kinematic quantities on the right-hand side are the velocity of the point B and the angular velocity. Now you will recall from our discussion on degrees of freedom that we only needed 3 quantities to describe the position of a rigid body in a plane, which was position of a reference point, let's say X and Y, and the angle or the orientation of the rigid body. And if you take the derivative of these, you get x dot, y dot, and theta dot. And these are the 3 things that you're actually seeing over here, right? So in this case, VB is the velocity of a reference point B, okay? And that point B could be basically the point xy whose derivative is given by x dot, y dot, right? And theta dot is right over here in omega AB. So this is where we have x dot B comma y dot B, and this is where we have theta dot AB. So it turns out that you need only 3 quantities to actually get the velocity of any point in a rigid body. If you know the velocity of a reference point, any reference point, and you know the rate at which that rigid body is rotating, then that information is enough to give you the velocity of any point in this rigid body. Right? So for example, on this rigid body, now I could pick another point C, and I wanted to write the velocity of C, knowing velocity of B and omega AB, the relationship would be VC equal to VB plus omega of BC cross R of C with respect to B. Now omega BC is the angular velocity of the line joining BC, which is this vector quantity, right? But that line is also going to be rotating at the same rate as AB. So omega BC is really equal to omega AB because this is a rigid body property. So what we get is BC equal to VB plus omega AB cross R of C with respect to B. So again, we just need to know velocity of one reference point. We need to know the angular velocity, and that will give us the velocity of any other point on this rigid body, right? Okay. All right, so now let's go ahead and take the derivative of this relationship over here once more, okay? So let's do that. So I'm going to write that relationship once more. Velocity of A equal to velocity of B plus omega AB cross R of A with respect to B. Okay, please don't make the mistakes with writing these position vectors. So don't write R of B with respect to A instead of R of A with respect to B, because if you do that, you know, this whole quantity will turn out to be negative and you'll get a different answer. Okay, all right, so let's take the derivative. So we get acceleration of A equal to acceleration of B plus omega dot AB cross R of A with respect to B plus omega AB cross R dot A with respect to B. Okay, so this is this, and what is this quantity now? Omega dot AB. So remember, omega AB is given as theta dot k hat, right? So theta dot is basically giving you the rate at which the orientation is changing. If you take the derivative of this, you get theta double dot k hat, because k hat, the derivative of k hat is going to be zero because k hat doesn't change its orientation, right? Remember, this is a translating frame that we have located at point B. It is not going to be allowed to rotate. So theta double dot is what we call the angular acceleration, okay? So we indicate this quantity as alpha AB, that's angular acceleration. So this becomes alpha AB cross R of A with respect to B plus omega AB cross R dot AB. What is R dot AB? R dot AB we have just done right over here. So R dot AB is this quantity. So this is where we did R dot AB. So that is equal to right over here, omega AB cross R of A with respect to B, right? Because we want to take the derivative of this. That's R dot AB. R dot AB is this quantity. So let's substitute that and we get omega AB cross R of A with respect to B. And that's the acceleration of A. So that's the relationship we had for the acceleration analysis. And that's basically half of this module. So the two fundamental relationships that we will need, one is the velocity relationship right over here, and the second is the acceleration relationship. With these two equations, we can solve pretty much every problem which involves a translating frame.